Mustang taxis out, right on cue, Tom arrives in the Boeing Stearman. Of course, the Stearman was designed by Stearman Aircraft, first flew in December 1933, but the company was taken over by Boeing in 1937. The PT-27, which was the export version for Canada.
Now, you know, it's a magnificent looking aircraft, quite different design features to the Spitfire. Came a little bit later, of course, in the design, but again, one of the Allied, our iconic fighter aircraft of World War II, flown by pretty well all the Allied air forces eventually, and certainly it was a bit of a game changer in many ways over Europe, with escorting bombers that had the range with tanks on to take those bombers further into occupied Europe.
Of course, first flown in October 1940, basically because the British Purchasing Commission went over to get Curtiss aircraft built by North American. They said to the commission, we will build you a better aeroplane in the same time that it takes to tool up to do the P-40. And they actually did that in record time. The first aircraft came out powered by the Allison engine, the same engine that was in the P-40. But later it was when the B model came out after Rolls-Royce and North American had done some collaboration. They put the fantastic Rolls-Royce Merlin in and the aircraft became the legend.
And the colour scheme of this one is in another legend.
You can see that beautiful paint scheme there, right the way down. The CO of 3 Squadron. The Southern Cross marking on the rudder there, ubiquitous. We actually looked at building the Spitfire and the P-47, but the Spitfire wing was considered to be too complex and the range of the aircraft too limited for Australian operations. The Mustangs produced in Australia actually came into service right at the end of the Second World War, then went up to Japan as part of the British Commonwealth Occupation Force and served actively with 77th Squadron during the Korean campaign.
This aircraft, I think you mentioned before, you know, the Merlin engine, of course, and they were produced by the British originally, and they it's to do with the exhaust stack and so on, but basically the same engine producing the same power output, and
approximately 200 of these aircraft flying around the world at the present time, and we're very fortunate to have about 7 of them flying here. One of them a P-51, but the rest CAC-built aeroplanes. Of course, Dick Hourigan was responsible for preserving this particular aircraft and all the way through to Berlin and back. 650 caliber machine guns could carry up to 2,000 pounds of bombs, and depended how it was configured, with either 6 underwing rockets and drop tanks or bomb craft on one of those missions, purely due to a thunderstorm. The May 1942, 250 of these built, and it was built as a stopgap fighter. The Japanese had cut off the supply line to Australia. And we'll just let that go. That's a fantastic sound, isn't it? That sound of the air going over the open gun ports.
Worked around or overcome.
the interesting things about the boomerang, it was actually designed by Lawrence Wackard and a gentleman by the name of Fred David. And Fred David was an Austrian Jewish refugee who had come to Australia, but he had vast experience working with Heinkel in Europe and also with the Japanese companies Aishi and Mitsubishi in Japan prior to the war. So he had the feel of fighter design. They put this together in record time using what components they had from the Wirraway production line.